Ooh, spooky. So, I normally would have a light on, except I think my light has gone out. And so this will be a very. I suppose I could leave my flashlight on. What does it look like if I don't have a light on at all? Pretty bad. And the light is in my eyes. I really don't like anything that's happening right now. I'm in this dark cave. I wonder if there's a way to diffuse the light. Let me try something. Take a pillowcase, maybe? Would that help? Nope, not good at all. It's more like I imagined, but still. I think that might have to do. Yeah, I might as well just. All right, oh well. This is too bad. As I go to a panel, I should light up. Okay. So let's just turn this other light on, and then when we're at panels, we should be able to see my face. We're not in just total darkness. That's what I was hoping. Yep, my light's either gone out or it's activated actually by this remote switch, which is a horrible design. Because if the battery in this dies, I can't turn that on, which is insane. Oh well. All right, so we're here to finish The Witness. I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to finish everything tonight. I know I have a few panels left. I've got the obelisk and I've got the desert shore puzzle. It is Tuesday, March 1st, the evening of. Clearly, let's go back on the light so you can see my face. A couple things. I was thinking more about the blue square puzzles, and I just went and I was actually gonna look at them while I was at work today, and I was watching the video, and I've kind of been assuming that that's a little weird how it sort of goes into the ground there. That doesn't look too believable at all. Look at the way that shadow goes up against the sky. That's not cool. Anyhow, yeah, that's weird. I'll take a screenshot of that for. Okay. I've kind of been assuming that, that I had done the wrong thing of maybe coming up with a rule for the tetromino blue square pieces and sort of stacked rules on top of that rule to make sense of whatever lines I was seeing. But like everything in this game, it should be quite simple in the end. The rules should be quite simple. You shouldn't have to have like multiple rules stacked on top of each other. Yes, the tetrominoes can move around, but really you just need the rule is the tetromino needs to be on the same side, and it needs to form the shape, or with multiple tetrominoes, a combination of the shapes, and that's it. The blue squares. If you watch the video of when I first encountered the blue squares, I'm a little confused at first because I'm just finding the mechanic for the first time. But I pretty much quickly figure out that oh, this is just a process of subtraction. Let's add up the yellow tetrominoes on the same side, and let's include a blue square on the same side, and subtract. The blue square, presumably in the same shape as the rest of the tetrominoes, that they're operating the same way. I don't recall exactly the line that threw me for a loop, where there was like multiple solutions that, which sort of seemed to complicate things for me. Maybe I was projecting onto that. I don't know. I have to go back and look. But my assumption now is that I can solve that puzzle if I just treat those tetrominoes as subtraction, because I did again. I did look at that video when I first encountered that puzzle, and sure enough, like I got it almost immediately. So I don't know exactly why that one's been giving me a problem since, because I seem to get it pretty early. But it is, when I do go to the cyan section, I think I end up. If you watch the videos, the first time I encounter that sequence, it seems like I get it pretty quickly, and then like some stuff happens, I get distracted, I have like close my blinds. I have to, like, the dogs come in the room, and so I'm like entertaining that, and they sit back down. It takes some time before I get back into the swing of things, so maybe that's where I threw myself for a loop and I started to sort of communicate differently, but I really don't know. I didn't really watch the full clip, but I just knew that I wanted to come back and approach it from a process of subtraction, so that's what I'm going to do. So that desert, the desert shore door, which presumably has a video behind it, I hope to get that done this evening. But while we're here, let's see if we can do the remaining panels, of which I think there are three, maybe two. Excuse the video as it cuts out as I go into dark areas. I'm only being lit by the television itself. Where are we headed? We are going this way. Oh, another thing that, I was talking to my friend Ben Esposito when I was watching the video of my encounter with the blue square puzzle, and it became clear that I've obviously known that, like, the placement of the recorders was important for some recorders, but I think for others it might not have been as immediately apparent to me that they were related to the mechanic, maybe because I listened to the recorder before I encountered the mechanic. But going back and listening to the recorder that's in the Tetramino piece, it talks about, like, how the universe doesn't distinguish between sort of negative space and positive space. And that's something that we ourselves carry. And sure enough, that mechanic there with the Tetramino piece is combining and separating and whatnot. Is similar to the thing that's tapered. It has something to, you know, some sort of correlation to the recorder itself. So I'd like to go back and listen to other recordings and reflect on them in context of and in correlation to the area that they're in the general puzzles that are nearby, whether those are panel puzzles or line puzzles. But anyhow, that's that. I'm going to proceed. So, just a combination Tetramino puzzle with a lot of possible rotations. Okay. Yeah, these negative spaces are a bit tricky. And this guy, right? Those are two things to look out for here. If the L was stand right here, or there. Now let's say right here, and one of these three guys was gonna go right on top of it, filling it in. Or what if it went this way? The Tetramino guy went that way. A three guy went that way. No, because he can't. So what if it went there, there? Nope. This is a little loopy. Trying to see what possible lines we can construct. It makes me want to take this guy and put him, like, inside one of these potential, like, three situations or something. I don't know. Let's see. The little hum is a little distracting. I want silence and ambience here. Just try this shape for now. Okay, so that's including the L in one of the triples. That's not gonna get us much. Nope. just like separate the general spacing of this. Hello, viewer. I don't know who you are, but we're watching The Witness. If you haven't played, I very much encourage you to play. We're at super late part of the game. I'm kind of doing some extra stuff. We'll see much more about that. But if you haven't played it all the way through yourself, and I do mean all the way through, everything here is going to be a spoiler. So I encourage you to play it yourself. It's a fantastic, fantastic game. Really above. It's really worth your time. Okay. We kind of already said that this isn't going to work. No, though. Right, that will not work. Okay. I like this guy standing upright only because it gets us closer to the rest of the pieces. That seems like something I'd want to do. The other thing we could do is, and the triple pieces you can't really create them without filling them in. So you kind of have to do some sort of interlocking. So maybe he has to interlock and he has to interlock. They maybe interlock into each other, or we use the single dot and one of the tips of this L to fill in that negative shape there. I'm gonna try connecting them together, potentially with a rotation on two different kinds of, I'll try them on like sort of inverses of each other, like one's pointing down, one's pointing up, and I'll also try them with alternate rotations. I'm gonna try to do this all in my head. So if you just like humor me here, don't like that. They could also just connect, like they could just sit in the same orientation side by side, like this. Like that could be the two triangle pieces. But that's not gonna give us what we need. This could be where the L goes, in which case that would give us a triangle here. That's the dot, that's the L. There it is. Ha 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 ha. Done. That wasn't too bad. Just had to figure out the right sort of combination of elements, and I liked using the L here. This is the one T, this is the other T, and then this is our single dot. This is gonna hurt my brain. So this, okay, you can kind of see them along on a diagonal here. So this, this, and this are the same color. Presumably this is also the same color because it's only a slight difference. This one also, so these are all of the same color here. And it's progressing, and maybe this, so these might be the same color. And this, and this, and this. Those I presumably, oh, and this. I don't know about this guy here. He might be, in which case this could all be. Yeah, that's all a single color. Uh-huh. And what about that orange up there? I'm a little unsure about him. Haha! Not too hard, huh? Not too hard. All right, well, the panels inside the mountain are done. In which case, we are about to go back outside. How would we want to go back outside? I think we have everything else, right? Let me just... Oh, no, there's panels down here that need to be done. Oh, and look at that. They're tetromino puzzles. Of course, I left the tetromino puzzles undone. Okay. Oh, and they're mirrored tetromino puzzles. I forgot I hadn't done these. Okay. Well, sorry for the dark screen. Okay. Well, the shapes can't rotate. Hello, new viewer. We're playing The Witness. We're really deep into the game. Some sort of disclaimer I give, I always give. The Witness is really good if you haven't played it all the way through, and I mean all the way through, like literally, I've already kind of finished the main part of the game. Everything's a spoiler, so I highly encourage you, if you haven't already, to play it yourself. It's well worth the money. Okay. With that, let's do this puzzle. Yeah, I don't think we're not going to get anything that just uses these two rows. It's going to sort of bleed out into this third row here at the least. Okay, let's just, I don't know, do that. Is that a thing? It's not a thing. That could never be a thing. What about, well, let's count the number. So 4, we have 7, 4, and 3. Okay. So we have 7 and 7, that's 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 12. So, I don't know. I didn't mean, I shouldn't have just done that. But this would give us the correct number of pieces. No. No, it wouldn't. 4, 8. That just gives us 10. 10, and we needed 4 more. So it would be like something like that. So, anyways, I'm just counting. Kind of shapes here. It would need a turn prior. I shouldn't wing it, I'm sorry. It's bad witnessing right there. So how many numbers? 4, 8. Let's see, we have 8, 10, 12, so that's not enough. So let's just say it goes like this. Nope, and there's one more I want to actually try before we actually study this thing further, which is this. Wait, 4, 8, 10, 12. Oop, that's not what I wanted to do. Sorry. Nope. Try that. Nope, okay. Let's figure out how these combine. Whoa, I want a dog. I want a dog. Okay. That's our L. I've already lost. Okay. If that's... Nope. So we have that. Nope. Maybe it's like something really strange, like, I don't even know. No, that's not ever gonna work. That's, no. Shouldn't bend it there. I don't know why I'm doing. This is not the way to solve witness puzzles. Okay, well, let's just try to create that shape. So, can these two pieces make the inverse of the same shape, given what's there? Well, I have a corgi in the corner of the room that's rubbing its face against stuff. Wait a minute. think. Okay, so if this goes with this and this goes with that, do they create the same, can they create the same shape just flipped? It's all about flipping. So just trying to think of, this could make like a fat L kind of thing. This also could make a fat L kind of thing. So let's look at that fat L. What I mean by that is if this corner were to go right over this guy, you'd have like a 1-3-3 column piece. Likewise, you could do the same here. A one. No, you'd have a 1-2-2-2. Those are not the same pieces. Okay. What if you had a 1-1-2-2-1? Can we create that? No. One, two, two, two. One, one, two, one. Nope. How about a two, 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 one, two. All right, well, we know that they at least, I don't know, let's see. We have that. And we have our L. Eight. That would be 16 pieces. Four, eight, 10, 12. The L can't go along the, I might be able to go along the ground. I don't know if I'm ready to make that call yet. I don't think the L goes on the bottom. I think it goes higher up. If which is, if that's the case. Nope. What if, oh, they don't need to be all part of the same shape. What am I doing? Oh, but that's only if they combine to see, be the same side. Okay, hold on. They probably are going to combine to be like this crazy cross puzzle, but maybe they don't need to be. 3, 2, 2, is that a thing? Nope. Two, 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 one with an oscillation. Three, three. Yeah. I guess that's kind of like a 1-3-3, but aren't they different? That one's going the long way, and that one's going. Yeah, those are not the same shape. There's no way to get. Yeah, once. Oh, I suppose I could do that too. Whoa. Oh. Okay. Try another one. Supposed to be where I started this or something? Whoa, three, this. Hold on, let's try that again. If we just isolate him, then we do three. Shit. Three. That, oh yeah, this was, that wouldn't suffice if the other guy was on the other side. That him. Three. That. No, because I'm isolating him. It doesn't work. Corner. Big guy. Corner, big guy, three and one. See, three, big guy. Big guy, three. corner. Oh, and one, but that won't work. Might need to separate one, maybe? Corner. Nope. One. Big guy. Nope. Corner. One. No. Nope. Three. Nope. So the three goes here. We do a corner and a one. We do a big guy. No. I do like coming all the way over here on this though. Not sure that that's the need, but let's see. So I just did. One off from that working. I need to let this dog out of the room. Sorry, one second. Big guy. 3-1. Oh, I can't do it. Wait, that wouldn't even be a thing. 3. Corner, big guy. Yeah, 3-1, but I can't do that. Is there another way of doing it? The same shape. Yes, there is. I can just go the other way. Aha. More panels, then we're out of the mountain. No, we got ones behind us, right? We get that one. Okay, good. Okay. L, let's say the L is here. Okay. And a two is here. Let's say this is the three, and either that or that is the one, and that this is the two. Maybe. This, L. I don't know if I like that. L. It's the two. No. So these are all going to have to be included. There's no way that he would do that. Three, two. Two. No. Let's say the L's there, okay? Just for whatever reason. This is the two. This is the three, and that's the one, but the one's on the other side, so we can't do that. Let's say the three goes here, okay? Three goes here. If that's the case, I need the one to go here and the two to go here. But that's not going to give us what we want. But what if the L goes here? The L goes here. The 2 goes here. The Tail goes here. The three goes here. The L goes here. Nope. Two, three. No. Two, three. No. Let's leave it three where it is. Three, two. Wait, what? Three, two. L and one. Wait. Duh. Okay. Okay. Say this is the L. Okay. L really wants to go here to make the most of that space, unless, yeah. Square two, yeah, because you can't do the L here, of course. I know, I'm just trying, because I'm stupid. Just kind of poke, it's like when you poke. Just sort of let your brain work, but you're not really actually trying to do actually good work. If the L is here, does it give us anything useful? It doesn't stack that high. Square two L square two. No, say I want that to then come up and go right. Hello, new viewer. Thanks for watching. We're playing The Witness. We're very late in The Witness. That's all my disclaimer. I always say we're very late in The Witness. If you haven't beaten it yourself, and literally finished the entire thing, you should stop watching and play. It's really good. And you're everything is a spoiler, so you will spoil this for you. Okay. Two square. No. L square, huh? L2, no. How am I gonna stack pieces that high? Oh, so the square goes da, da, da. The square is that guy. That's what we need. And the L will stay at the bottom. Well, how's that gonna work? Is it like, oh, it's like this? No, that's not gonna work. Very close, very close. We have to include him or avoid him. And it's seeming more and more like that we have to avoid him. Hold on. No, the two happens up here. That's the two. That's the square. That's the L. Bang. Okay, let's try that again. Assuming, my guess is with this the last panel, these are actually gonna make up this guy, or but who knows? So if that's the two, that's the square. Yeah. say, or we're going to avoid him entirely. No, that's probably not what's going to happen. No, we're not going to avoid him entirely. Unless it goes 3, 2, nope. And then 2, square, 3, nope. Because he stands on the other side. Let's isolate one. 2. Square. Three, no. So can I create that? Oh, I can do that. That's easy. Haha. It's like a little fake puzzle. It's like, oh, you don't know how to play this game, do you? Three and square. Little trick, little trick. All right, and this one. So it's just a process of subtraction, right? So if this is the L, and this is the square. L, and we're gonna subtract 2 diagonal that way. So if this is the L and this is the square, can we subtract those two? How are we gonna subtract those two? Hold on. L and square. Feel like I need to create, include a wall. So the square is here. Oh, so I think their corners are going to touch, and that's how we're going to create the shape. Like either this corner to that guy, or this corner to that guy, or this corner to that guy. Let's try the weirdest one, which is this corner, I think would be this corner to there. Or actually, what's the one that's going to actually create that shape? It's actually not wide enough. Hold on, we can do that one. Right, so we can do, like, that's like more or less a shape that we could kind of make. But they also need to be on the same side of the line. Oh, I think I have another idea. Let me see. Nope. It's a little hard to think of these shapes. So just think of all the combinations that they could sit in. put the square on the bottom. How about that? I don't want to put the square on the bottom though, because of the displacement of this guy here. Let's just say the L goes where it goes here. Okay, if that's how they're combined, they can be combined that way. If that's how they're combined. Is there any way to subtract while keeping them in line? I don't think there is. Okay. No, I don't think that works. So that's the line I tried just now. This is a funky shape. I need to think about how to deal with it. Is it just subtraction? Oh, hold on. If this were the square, and this were the L, no. If this were the square, damn. Oh, excuse me, sorry. Have a sip of beer, why not? Rack the brain. This is the first blue we've done in a while, right? Yes. Oh, look at that.
God bade me behold the sea, and I saw the ship sinking and the planks floating. Then the planks, too, were submerged. And God said to me, those who voyage are not saved. And he said to me, those who, instead of voyaging, cast themselves into the sea, take a risk. And he said to me, those who voyage and take no risk shall perish. And he said to me, in taking the risk, there is a part of salvation. And the wave came and lifted those beneath it and overran the shore. And he said to me, the surface of the sea is a gleam that cannot be reached, and the bottom is a darkness impenetrable. And between the two are great fishes, which are to be feared. Nefari, circa 970.
I thought I had heard that.
What?
I'm going to the store. Do you want a sandwich or something?
You've been standing there for like an hour.
I didn't want to interrupt.
And I don't like sandwiches. Have you ever seen me with a sandwich? Why would you think I want a sandwich?
Sorry.
No, I need some sleep.
It's okay. We're all working hard.
I just want to read it right. We're going to be hearing this a lot of times. Every little thing matters because it gets so multiplied.
It's good. It's already good.
Thanks. Yeah. But we've kind of picked high goalposts. Every little bit matters. Oh, can you get me a coffee?
I kind of like that this rock is like pushing into me right here. It's like, I mean, it calls attention more to the fact that this is sort of crumbled and caved in on this track. Where did this track go? It just ends, huh? That's it. Okay, Chris. If that is our, let's just say, that's a thing. Nope, sorry. I want to play with this shape, but it doesn't seem like that's going to go over too well, because it needs to be on the same line. Like, this is not going to, how am I gonna do that? I can't. That's another one I could do, I suppose. And then how do I kill two from that? I don't. Do I? I don't. No, I can't. Because it's just gonna... I can't. I'm gonna include it. What is up? Are there more rules to this? Is it just subtraction? I wish I could go back and study. I mean, I can go back to the swamp and study. I'm actually not that far away. The swamp is very nearby. I'm sorry, I'm not reading messages, I apologize. For risk of spoilers, I don't need to solution, but I'm a little concerned that I might need to go refresh my memory about how this works. My understanding is that the yellows combine as normal, and then these are just a matter of subtraction. I have to subtract that shape from the combined yellow shape. That's how I understand it. Now, so if this is, so if we just imagine, sorry, it just dawned on me what I had to do there. I can explain that if, sorry, I know that's the sort of thing that happens in The Witness where suddenly you just get it. So the way it works is the square goes here, the L goes here, fitting into the slot that's omitted. So the top of the L becomes the bottom right corner of the square. And so you've omitted the bottom right, and then we omit the top left. And that gives us all three shapes. Cool? Cool. Well, it looks like we've fully completed all the panels except for one in the entire game, at least of the panels that we know of. I might be overlooking something or forgetting, but that's my guess. I did see that Twitch message. I'm just going to go back and check to make sure that there's nothing left undone here. Nope, everything is good. Everything's on and working. Up here, everything's lit up. Everything's good. We're good. We're good. We're good. Okay. Anything down here? It's quite the... It's like a ravine used to come down here. I wouldn't be surprised if I'm missing like a tape recorder somewhere in this area, but this could be easy to miss. So we have one panel presumably remaining in the entire game, and then it'll be about getting obelisks. This is not the way I want to go. Oh, and there's probably a line puzzle in here that's not the... This is a line puzzle right there, but... I guess is there's one or two more, since the obelisk seems to point the way into the mountain. All right, let's head out this way. There's a tape recorder right there, but we've got it. Now, where is another line puzzle? There has to be another one in this mountain. It's not my chief concern right now. My chief concern is doing the final panel puzzle in the entire game. Insofar as we know. And unlocking the, presumably, the last video in the game. Where are we going? Is this the way out? Wait, let's... Okay. Yes. Is there no tape recorder in here? Looking for lines. Is that light just like clipping into the wall? What is that about? I'm gonna take a screenshot of that. That does not look intentional. That looks like a weird art bug. I'll have to report these back to the team. I wonder if there's... No, that wouldn't be a tape recorder underwater. I keep wanting to see if there's... Oh, that looks like a line puzzle, doesn't it? Right there? This? Doesn't that look like it could become a line in the water? That sure does. It sure does. Is there a place above that I can get to? I know that's a line puzzle right there, but. I'm curious about the specificity of that line. Let's go down there and check from another angle. Excuse me. This is. This is going to drive me insane. I can't leave this up like this. Aha. Have I gotten this already? I have gotten that. Or have I? I can't tell. Looks like I have.
Then the occupant of the first would shout to keep him clear. And if the other did not hear it the first time, nor even when called three times, bad language would inevitably follow. In the first case, there was no anger. In the second, there was.
It's gotta be
in
a
the
puzzle.
first case, the boat was empty. And in the second, it was occupied.
All right, I remember
And so
this.
it is with man. If he could only roam empty through life, who would be able to injure him?
Cool.
Sue, 4th century BC. How did it go?
Oops.
I don't know. I don't remember. No, it's normal for me. I never remember my dreams. If I try right when I wake up, I can just barely remember
fragments. I wonder if this is a line puzzle.
Later, those fragments.
It's only accessible while on the elevator.
Later,
Traveling
it's
midway.
like these are ramblings of a crazy person.
Yeah, but then how do we know there aren't any side effects? I mean, do you remember everything else about life?
It's fine. I mean, we're just doing suppression, not lobotomies. I mean, everything is still there. In dreams, we often take on personalities that are a little different. We forget details of our waking life and remember fictions in their place. How does that happen? Well, we're just using the same pathways. It's fine. But really, how should I know if something's missing? If you forget a few random little things, how would you remember that you forgot? Nothing big is missing. I don't think. How are you again?
Why did we let you go first?
First hasn't happened yet. I was just dipping my toes into the pool. Real first happens when someone dives right in and gets to decide for themselves when to come out. Who's that gonna be? You?
I long for the days when you weren't sure we'd be doing anything this
All right.
scary.
It'll be fine. It's not scary. It'll be fun.
So fun you don't even remember?
Okay, no. Shoo. I want to re-record this one before I go home. I have some new ideas about it.
What? Because of the test?
Yes. Because of the test. Possibly.
I thought you didn't remember anything. Interesting.
Yeah. Have a good night. I'll see you tomorrow.
I studied this recording this morning. I have all sorts of questions about the recordings. Where am I going? I'm going to the desert. So is this going to be it? This is going to be the final panel. Left undone in The Witness. And then it'll just be about finishing the couple, maybe three or four obelisks, puzzles. Not obelisks. I have all but two obelisks remaining. Look at that. It's like Monet, but done with. The angle of, what's it? Incidence. Okay. And here we are. Two, one, and one. I have to create a shape that oops. See, there's no way to subtract four squares from a... What if it's as simple as negating the T-shape with those guys? So they just sort of undo him in a way. And then we finish by wrapping around this piece. So, you know, we do something like this. That's not gonna work. So he's... Nope. Hmm. I want to do something like that, essentially. What am I doing here? Come on. Or maybe. No, that won't work either. I feel like I'm close, but maybe I'm not. Who knows? I like when I come wide here. But I'm still gonna end up with the same problem I have. I need to go the other way. So let's look at what this looks like before I finish. As in, like that. Can I essentially do that and wrap myself all the way? Okay, I can do this. I think I can do this. Wait, but what about that guy? Aha. What do we have here? It's dark. Corner of the world. All right. Simple enough. Let's go do it.
Here we go. It's like that? No, it's like this. No. Close. Hold on. That's not that. Oh, it's like this.
And so, by a backhand and upside down argument,
is that Feynman?
Predicted that there is in carbon a level of 7.82 million volts, and then experiments in the laboratory with carbon show indeed that there is. And therefore, the existence in the world of all these other elements is very closely related to the fact that there is this particular level in carbon. But the position of this particular level in carbon seems to us, after knowing the physical laws, to be a very complicated accident of 12 complicated particles interacting. So I wish to illustrate by this example that an understanding of the physical laws doesn't give you an understanding in a sense of understanding the world in any way. The details of real experience are very far often from the fundamental laws. There are, in a way of speaking in the world, we have a way of discussing the world, which you could call, we discuss it at various hierarchies or levels. Now, I don't mean to be very precise, there's a level of another level and another level, but I will indicate by describing a set of ideas to ideas. For example, at one end, we have the fundamental laws of physics. Then we invent other terms for concepts which are approximate, who have, we believe, the ultimate explanation in terms of the fundamental laws. For instance, heat. Heat is supposed to be the jiggling, and it's just a word for a hot thing is just a word for a mass of atoms which are jiggling. For all that, fundamentally, we should think of the atoms jiggling. But for a while, if we're talking about heat, we sometimes forget about the atoms jiggling. Just like when we talk about the glacier, we don't always think of the hexagonal ice snowflakes which originally fell. Another example of the same thing is a salt crystal. Looked at fundamentally, it's a lot of protons, neutrons, and electrons. But we have this concept, salt crystal, which carries a whole pattern already of fundamental interactions, or idea like pressure. Now, if we go higher up from this, in another level, we have properties of substances like refractive index, how light is bent when it goes through something, or surface tension. The fact that the water tends to pull itself together is described by a number. I remind you that we have to go through several laws down to find out that it's the pull of the atoms and so on. But we still say surface tension. And don't worry when we're discussing surface tension of the inner workings always. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. Go on, up in the hierarchy. With the water, we have the waves, and we have a thing like a storm. We have a word for storm, which represents an enormous mass of phenomena. Or sunspot. Or star, which is an accumulation of things. And it's not worthwhile always to think of it way back. In fact, we can't, because the higher up we go, we have too many steps in between, each one of which is a little weak, and we haven't thought them all through yet. And we go up in this hierarchy of complexity, we get to things like frog, or nerve impulse, which you see is an enormously complicated thing in the physical world, involving an organization of matter in a very elaborate complexity. And then we go on, we come to things, words, and concepts like man and history or political expediency and so forth, which is a series of concepts that we use to understand things at an ever higher level. And going on, we come to things like evil and beauty and hope. Now, which end is nearer to the ultimate creator, or the ultimate, or if I make a religious metaphor, which end is nearer to God? Beauty and hope or the fundamental laws. I think that the right way, of course, is to say that the whole structural interconnections of the thing is the thing that we have to look at, and that the sequence of hierarchy, that all the sciences and all the efforts, not just the sciences, but all the efforts of intellectual kind, are to see the connections of the hierarchies is to connect beauty to history, is to connect history to man's psychology, the man's psychology to the working of the brain to the neural impulse to the chemistry, and so forth, up and down, both ways. And today we cannot, and there's no use making believe we can, draw carefully a line all the way from one end of this thing to the other. In fact, we've just begun to see that there is this relative hierarchy. And so I don't think either end is nearer to God's. And if to stand at either end and to walk out off the end of the pier only, hoping out in that direction is the complete understanding, is a mistake. And to stand with evil and beauty and hope, or to stand with the fundamental laws, hoping that way to get a deep understanding of the whole world, with that aspect alone, is a mistake. And it is not sensible either for the ones who specialize at one end and the ones who specialize at the other end to have such disregard for each other. They don't, actually, but the people say they do. But that actually the great mass of workers in between, connecting one step to another, are improving all the time our understanding of the world, both from working at the ends and working in the middle. And in that way, we are gradually understanding this connection, this tremendous world of interconnecting hierarchies.
If you expected science to give all the answers to the wonderful questions about what we are, where we're going, what the meaning of the universe is, and so on, then I think you could easily become disillusioned and then look for some mystic answer to these problems. How a scientist can take a mystic answer, I don't know, because the whole spirit is to understand. Well, never mind that. I don't understand that. But anyhow, if you think of it, the way I think of what we're doing is we're exploring. We're trying to find out as much as we can about the world. People say to me, are you looking for the ultimate laws of physics? No, I'm not. I'm just looking to find out more about the world. And if it turns out there is a simple ultimate law that explains everything, so be it. That would be very nice to discover. If it turns out it's like an onion with millions of layers and we're just sick and tired of looking at the layers, then that's the way it is. But whatever way it comes out, its nature is there and she's going to come out the way she is. And therefore, when we go to investigate it, we shouldn't pre-decide what it is we're trying to do except to find out more about it. If you say, but your problem is why do you find out more about it? If you thought that you were trying to find out more about it because you're going to get an answer to some deep philosophical question, you may be wrong. It may be that you can't get an answer to that particular question by finding out more about the character of nature. But I don't look at it. My interest in science is to simply find out about the world. And the more I find out, the better it is. I like to find out. There are very remarkable mysteries about the fact that we're able to do so many more things than apparently animals can do. And other questions like that. But those are mysteries I want to investigate without knowing the answer to. And so altogether, I can't believe the special stories that have been made up about our relationship to the universe at large, because they seem to be too simple, too connected, too local, too provincial. The Earth, he came to the Earth. One of the aspects of God came to the Earth, mind you. And look at what's out there. How can it isn't in proportion. Anyway, it's no use arguing. I can't argue it. I'm just trying to tell you why the scientific views that I have do have some effect on my beliefs. And also, another thing has to do with the question of how do you find out if something's true? And if you have all these theories of the different religions, have all different theories about the thing, then you begin to wonder. Once you start doubting, just like you're supposed to doubt, you ask me, is the science true? You say, no, we don't know what's true. Trying to find out everything is possibly wrong. Start out understanding religion by saying everything is possibly wrong. Let us see. As soon as you do that, you start sliding down an edge, which is hard to recover from. And so with the scientific view, or my father's view, that we should look to see what's true and what may not be true, once you start doubting,
which I think to me is a very fundamental part of my soul, is to doubt and to ask. And when you doubt and ask, it gets a little harder to believe. You see, one thing is I can live with doubt and uncertainty and not knowing. I think it's much more interesting to live not knowing than to have answers which might be wrong. I have approximate answers and possible beliefs and different degrees of certainty about different things, but I'm not absolutely sure of anything, and there are many things I don't know anything about, such as whether it means anything to ask why we're here and what the question might mean. I might think about it a little bit. If I can't figure it out, then I go to something else. But I don't have to know an answer. I don't feel frightened by not knowing things, by being lost in a mysterious universe without having any purpose, which is the way it really is, as far as I can tell, possibly. It doesn't frighten me.
Now what? How, oh how, does this close? A circle there, a line around. How, oh how, does this close? And how might it relate to the panels beneath it? I don't know.
I will indicate by describing a set of ideas to you, just one after the other, what I mean by hierarchies of ideas. And there are many things I don't know.
Why, oh why? I mean, clearly there's a line here. But can I close those doors? Were they open to begin with? Did I open them? Have they always been open? Did I do something to open them? And if not, if they've always been as they are, how do I get these line puzzles that are so obviously here?
So it's absolutely simple. What I have to say to you. It's what my teacher said to me.
It just looks like, I mean, I guess this wall doesn't retract, does it? Or does it? Does this wall retract? No. No, this is just green beneath the frame. And if that is so, how then do we turn it into a light? What are you about? What is your deal? I'm gonna go look at the obelisk for answers. Where is the obelisk down here? There and there, right? This is the yellow, this is the green, and then this is the leaves above. What must I do? This is the green. Oh, wow. I see now. It's going to use the video itself. Aha. I think it's the first video when he uses the cell, when he comes in on the cell.
Because it removes the reassuring crutches of opinion, ideology, and leaves only what is demonstrably true about the world.
Hold on.
It's hard to take, because it removes the reassuring crutches of opinion, ideology, and leaves only what is demonstrably true about the world. Because it removes the reassuring crutches of opinion, ideology, and leaves only what is demonstrably true. And the reason why so many people may be thinking about throwing away those crutches.
I doubt it uses the same video. It might, but I doubt it. That already has one, so I'm not gonna use that. No, we've done him. I'm surprised there isn't one in there. If there is,
it's what my teacher said, and I'm still
maybe.
Deeply.
Maybe it will use.
Things like that, as opposed to this. No one.
Hold on.
Understand.
Aha.
It's hard to take because it removes the reassuring crutches of opinion, ideology, and leaves.
Okay. Now let's go up there, and then we need. the missing... We need... What video is going to use the leaves? This is the solution. It's a hand? I didn't notice the hand before.
Well, that's no better a solution than any of the others, is it?
What is it going to be? If it even uses these at all. I've done this. I've used this. I've used... Nope, not that. I've used, done two with that. Not that all of them have to use it. Let's get an image. Let's get an image for it. Oh, I can mess with the videos from above, can't I? Or can I not? Oh, it's going to be right there. It's going to fill in right here. Okay. Can I change the videos from here? I cannot. Okay. It'll be right here. That part of the video screen, or more or less the right half of the video screen. Okay. Knowing that, let us return. Good puzzles, good puzzles. Even at the end of the game, still impressing me. Is it just his face? Is it like the top of his glasses? His eyeball? Is it something in here? Like Jesus? Is it actually Jesus with his halo? Seeing if this glasses have anything, because that ability's there, as long as it's explained clearly enough. And then go and ask for it. Right. And if you're thinking right now, what do I ask for? Ask yourself if there's anything in your life that you want to change. That's what it's done. Wait, did I miss it? What? Ha ha ha.
This is very exciting. It's kind of sad at the same time, though. It's been quite the experience. Oh, I started afterwards. Oh, maybe it was that, this painting, right? Was it the, yeah, it's that right there. That's the one. I have no idea if I gave this enough time. Probably not. Why is it the book open? Quick.
As opposed to this.
Oh.
It's a bunch of amino acids. The stuff that goes to build up.
I might have missed it.
Or you. This stuff's easier to take.
Aha. One less mystery. And with that, we should have one. That obelisk should be done. I believe. I might be wrong about that. Oh no, I still have the yellow flowers at the start. What is that about? Well, it's the desert. Those still evade me. I have no idea what to make of them right now. So it's still black, but we have the flowers at the start, and we have the final gate, which we cannot do. What's the situation here? The yellow flowers are not blooming across. Really, it has me standing here, but it does not connect. What a weird puzzle. Alright, well, doesn't look like I'll be getting the obelisk, which is, I might have to start a new game, and yeah, because if I, no, I can't, because if I do the gate, and it takes me, to the end with the video, doesn't it say start new game after that? I know where both of those are. Let's go check out the other obelisk that we don't have. Sorry, I was texting Luis, who's the artist on, or one of the artists on this game, that I got all the line puzzles in the video room. Okay. And so, we're missing how many? Just one? Nope. Two. Starting low and moving up. Starting up and moving across. And presumably are both in this direction, if not underground itself, or atop the mountain. I'm still surprised I haven't found one that relates to her hand, especially given that it kind of... Oh, is that another cloud puzzle? Does the cloud move there? Down, around, and over this way. Sure doesn't look like the shape of her arm. Unless that's just her hand, like her thumb. No. Or... this becomes the end of a line puzzle. That was a weird hitch. Where is this moving cloud, anyways? It doesn't seem like it's over here. Is it orbiting the mountain? Is that cloud moving? It is moving. It is moving. The whole cloud is moving. Damn. But it's just that one. Damn. Can I see it from out in that? Not cool. Starts low and goes up. Not sure if I should do these right now. It's 12:14, yeah, I should stop. Oh, it's too bad. I'm so very close. But it's gonna take time. And I'm still at a loss for that starting obelisk. It's very unclear what I should do about that. Yep, the cloud totally moves. Oh, excuse me. Maybe from a certain angle. that will resemble what I'm looking for. We shall return tomorrow with more witness. Thanks for watching, everybody. Good. There's like four more lines to do, two of which we've identified the positions of, but don't know how to. Well, one of which I don't know how to get without starting the game over. So it might just be an impossibility, unless it's like suddenly reactivated once I do all the other obelisks. Like it's the one that's. I don't know. Like maybe that yellow flower is just the one, like blossoms when I finally finish all the obelisks except for the final gate, and then it's bloomed, and then when I do it, it turns the gate back on, I guess. It'd be weird. That's the only sort of way I could see me being able to get everything. And then we have the two that are presumably over here. I'm not sure if one involves that moving cloud. I know they already did the moving cloud over here, so it kind of seem a little redundant. Like you can already see as it comes back, it makes its way around the mountain. Well, this is a spoiler if you haven't already done this cloud puzzle, but, you know, so don't look, but I just kind of already gave it away, unfortunately. But yeah, that's going to come in. These are all going to slide. And that's going to become, right, so we just use the side of this. So maybe that's not this line puzzle. I don't know. There's a couple over here. There's a couple in the starting area. And that's everything. It's kind of amazing that that's everything, but that's everything. And maybe some tape recorders that we might have missed, but I don't know how to log those right now. But anyways, thanks for watching. I'll probably be back on tomorrow evening to try to finish things up if I can be so successful. Good night.